truths. Surely among the most magnificent of all God's creatures. Powerful. Majestic. Beautiful. Wolves are not only one of the most intelligent creatures on the planet, but their relationships with one another often expose the many flaws in ours. Oh, what we could learn from them if only our hearts were as pure as theirs. But sadly, what's in our hearts does not allow us to see them as the beautiful creatures of God they are, whose divinely inspired manner of doing things can show us how to live better, more productive lives ourselves, but as expendable objects to satisfy our egos. Some suffer horrific abuse at the hands of trappers and hunters, while many born in captivity live their entire lives chained or caged, only to endure a lifetime of chronic fear and despair. The Bible says a righteous man cares for the needs of his animals, but even the kindest acts of the wicked are cruel. Funny, this verse doesn't exactly mention our wants or needs, only those of the animals. If the shoe fits, I guess. No wonder these intelligent creatures shy away from us. Spent the better part of a decade in direct contact with dozens of these awesome creatures, allowing them to teach me how to interact with them on their terms and according to their rules with each encounter, I am convinced that there's nothing of value we can teach them, and our insensitive attempts to alter their natural, divinely inspired manner of doing things to meet our selfish needs only prevents us from learning what God's trying to teach us about ourselves and our motives through them. Things so profound they simply cannot be described in words. If only we could open our hearts and allow these awesome animals to be who and what they naturally are, we could learn what God is trying to teach us about ourselves, our motives, and our lives through their examples, and in doing so, move closer to receiving the more fulfilling life God wants for us. I am haunted by images of neglect and abuse of these majestic creatures. They are permanently etched into my soul. Jordan, Kyra, Maggie, Joshua. But there's good news. If you love your animals and hope to see them again as I do, a new day really is coming. A day when every form of evil will be banished from the face of the earth. And that includes man's lack of empathy for God's creatures. Just as animals were part of God's original, untainted creation, before sin entered the world through us, they'll be part of the world when He restores it. In that day, the wolf and the lamb will live together, the leopard will lie down with the baby goat, the calf and the yearling will be safe with the lion, and a little child will lead them all. Oh, do I look forward to seeing all of my furry friends again. For many, that day will bring unimaginable joy. Presently, these majestic creatures are dependent on us for their care. So until this day comes, we'll continue to care for them as best we can, and we'll try not to miss what God is trying to teach us about ourselves, our motives, and life along the way. We believe what the Bible says regarding creation, that God made all things through Christ Jesus. And as we await His return, we believe that animals, especially those that endure much pain and sorrow while here in this world, also look forward to that day. As unlike us, they do not know right from wrong, and therefore they were never separated from Him. While our physical bodies die, our souls never die. They are eternal, and will reside in the eternity we choose. But God did not create animals with the ability to choose right or wrong, or to accept or reject Him. Only humans were given these options. Therefore, we believe that all of our beloved animals that have gone before us are now with Him, as they are completely innocent of any wrongdoing. Many people do not believe that animals have souls. But our souls are comprised of our mind, our will, and our emotions, all of which are shaped throughout the trials and hardships of this life for a divine and eternal purpose. Now, I don't know about you, but I've never known an animal that didn't have a mind to think, a will to pursue its desires, and the full spectrum of emotions. Therefore, like us, they too have a divine purpose, as I believe their souls are also being shaped throughout this life just as ours. If that were not the case, then all of their suffering here in this fallen world would be for nothing. And I do not believe our loving God allows any soul, man or animal, to experience pointless suffering that does not have a specific and extremely valuable divine purpose for its eternal benefit. Do you know Him? The Bible says that Jesus' death on the cross paid for all sin, past, present, and future, once and for all. It also says that during our lives in this fallen world, we would share in His suffering through the trials and tribulations of living in a fallen world. The Bible also says that this, our suffering, is nothing compared to the wonderful eternity He has planned for those who love Him and trust Him with their salvation. Now, since His death on the cross paid for all sin once and for all, and our suffering while here on this earth, according to Scripture, is sharing in Christ's suffering, then if death was the end of the road for our beloved animals, who suffer tremendously as a result of man's sin, wouldn't their suffering while here on this earth be additional payment for sin? Thus making the Bible's claim that Jesus' death on the cross paid for all sin, at best, less than accurate? Well, I believe it would. So based on the Bible, every word of which I believe to be God's pure truth, we, by faith, believe that the animal suffering while here on this earth is nothing more than their part of sharing in Christ's suffering as a result of living in a fallen world, which again, is the result of what man did, not the animals. Therefore, we believe that they too await His return and will experience eternal life and the glory of the Lord for eternity, just as people who trust Him as their Savior. Think about how much we love our animals, the pain it causes us when they suffer, and how often we're powerless to help them in these situations. Now, consider the immeasurable difference between our limited capacity to love and empathize and God's immeasurable capacity to love and empathize. A God who gave His own Son as a sacrifice for us, and then consider how much more the suffering of His innocent animals hurts Him than it hurts us when He knows better than we that the animals, unlike man, have never known or committed any type of sin, nor have they ever had an evil or immoral thought. Now, can you really argue that all God planned for our beloved animals were lives of pointless suffering and then death, when according to Scripture, Jesus' death on the cross paid for all man's sin in full? I can't. So, based on the aforementioned scriptures, and what I've learned in this life about God's immeasurable love for us and all of His creation, I believe we will see our beloved animals again in their perfect, healthy, glorified bodies, and that we'll experience them in the unimaginable way God pre-planned for us, with a much higher level of love, communication, and intimacy than that which we experience with them